Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Kendra, and if this is your first time, please do not make it your last by clicking the subscribe button down here. It is red, it is free. Please let's get this channel to 300 subscribers by the end of next week. So if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. I hope you enjoyed the last video as well as other videos that I have been making. So I make educational and career videos. In my last video, I talked about reading my Commonwealth shared scholarship essays. So I read my development impact essay as well as study plan essays, and so that was the part one. The video was getting long, so this is the second part of that video. In this video, I'll be reading my objectives during the award essay, career plan, as well as volunteering and leadership essays. So if this is something you want to see, please keep on watching this video, and please hit the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. Let me know if you enjoyed the video in the comment section. Let's get into the video. So first off, we're going to start with the objectives during the award essay. So please, if you see me looking this way, I'm just referring to my laptop because I have the essay there on my screen, and I'll be reading some parts of it like I did in the last video. So for the objectives during the award, also if I look down, I've made some notes here, so please forgive that. Objectives during the award, they're basically just asking you why you're here doing your studies, what are you going to achieve, what do you hope to do besides learning. Yeah, they know you're going to learn. You've told them your study outline, right? They know you're going to study, but besides that, what do you hope to achieve in your study as well as in your stay here in the UK? So the first point I would say is always relate your objectives to your career goals. So whatever objectives you're saying, you want to learn this skill, you want to learn that, make sure it is in line with your career, your long-term career, your short-term career. Make sure they are all in line. So let's say you're studying biomedical sciences and you're saying that your objectives is to learn catering or learn how to make donuts. I mean, it has no business with your career path. You always have to make sure that your objectives during the award are in line with your career path, whatever your career path is. Also, you should talk about the skills you want to learn. If there's any skill that your course is going to teach you, for instance, maybe you're studying epidemiology or public health, let's say you're going to learn biostatistics, maybe you're going to learn how to use statistical method, you're going to learn some other skills, maybe you're going to have a laboratory posting or laboratory attachment or a professional experience. You can say that you would want to learn this skill, so please mention specific skills. Again, also refer to the department website of the school you're applying to and see what the course entails, because there you see specific modules, you see the specific things you're going to learn, if there's going to be any practical skill you're going to learn, or maybe any soft skill you've been learning, you see it there. So always check out the department website, the school's website you want to apply to. And please pardon the noise in the background if you can hear it. I'm so sorry about that. Moving on, I'm going to go ahead and, you know, because I realize that the problem most people have is how to begin the essays. What sentence should I write? Personally, whenever I'm writing essays, I always like to start with a general sentence. So I'm talking about my objectives. So I'm thinking of, basically, I'm coming here to learn this in general, to learn how to do this in general, and then I'll start breaking it down. So your first sentence, your introductory sentence, should give the person an overview of everything you want to achieve or your objective, your general objective during your award or your study in the UK. And then your following sentences can break those things down into bits. My first sentence, like I said, I'll be referring to this side of the screen. So my first sentence says, during this award, I hope to acquire in-depth knowledge on the factors affecting the lack of effective and efficient policies and management practices in the healthcare systems of developing countries. So if you've been listening, if you watched the previous video, which I'll put up here, please, if you've not seen that video, kindly go check it out. It is the part one of this video. So in the previous video, I kept mentioning that I want to learn policies, policy making, policy management, and how to implement policies in low and middle income countries. And so generally what I want to learn from this course, this is factors affecting the poor implementation of, why are these policies not working in developing countries? Why are health policies not working there? What are the factors? So that is like my general objective. So start your essay your essay with a general view of, so even if that is the only thing someone looks at, they will know that, okay, this is basically what this person is saying. And please make sure that it's also related to everything you've been writing, because everything has to flow. Also, I talked about my research, right? So how I wanted to gain research skills, you can mention that if that is something you're interested in. And then you can talk about volunteering, extracurricular activities that you'd want to do. If there's any place that you'd like to visit, let's say for instance you're studying maybe archaeology, or you're studying ancient history and you want to visit this popular museum, you want to visit this architectural space, or you want to visit this laboratory, or you want to visit this big place that is very popular and relevant to your career, you can say that you would love to visit this place and, you know, see what they are doing. Maybe you volunteer at that place to gain like some form of experience. So you also mentioned that, because this is where it comes in. I also mentioned the connections I'll be making with my lecturers, other international students or students from the UK. Talked about networking as well. So if that is something you hope to achieve here, or you want to visit the Queen's Castle, you can write that. You know, just talk about personal things you want to do, as well as, you know, so you build it up, or no, you break it down. So start from your general objective. Of course, you're coming here to study, that should be your basic priority. You're coming here to gain knowledge and skills. So after talking about that, you can talk about other professional objective. Maybe you want to attend a conference, you want to attend a workshop or something, you can include it. In fact, if there's a conference you know that is coming up in the year when you're going to be in the UK, you can include that and even include the date or where it's going to be held and say you'd love to attend this conference. So that is a tip. And finish off your essay by saying you really want to experience these things as they would help you, you know, progress in your career, your future career. Just end it with a very catchy sentence as well. Now we'll be going into career plans in 5 years following the award. So you have like the short term and then the long-term career plan. So your short-term career plan, I mentioned this earlier in the last video. Also, if you've not seen that video, please click up here and go watch it right now or after this video. I'm going to put it also at the end of this video so you can check it out. So I mentioned in the other video that if you have something you're doing already, ensure to build on that. If you have, let's say you want to go and you have an NGO, you have a business, you have a job, a research you're doing, you can build on that. You can tell them, presently I'm a so thing at so place, and coming back, my first point of contact would be to do this and do that, you know, building on what I already have back here in my home country, wherever you're coming from. So it's okay for you to build on that. In fact, it makes it realistic, because you're not like starting from the scratch anymore. You just want to gain more knowledge and more skills to, you know, finish off what you've started, or to expand on what you've started doing already, if that makes sense. Like I mentioned before, I was a graduate assistant before I left, and I actually wanted to learn like teaching skills from the UK as well. Not just teaching skills, research skills, and, you know, how policies, health policies are, you know, implemented and run in the UK. So I wanted to learn all that. So this is how I started my own sentence or my essay. So I said, presently a graduate assistant in my university, in bracket I put the name of the university, I hope to be promoted to an assistant lecturer, and this will enable me to handle academic classes more effectively, thereby impacting my knowledge directly to the students. So like I said in my previous video, which again, if you've not watched it, I'm sorry, I'm saying this again because a lot of people might not understand if they've not seen that video. So like I mentioned before, this is the first point of contact, the first thing I'm going to do, because it doesn't need any capital. It's not as if I'm establishing an organization, I'm starting a business, or I'm opening a hospital. No, this is just something I have to like pass on, like a knowledge base I have to pass on. So it's realistic, it's understandable. So someone tells you, assuming you're working in a company and you're going for your master's, and you're telling your company that, oh, once you're done, you're going to become a better employee, is more realistic than saying that, oh, once you come back, you're going to break down this company and build another one. You know, it might require a lot of manpower, a lot of resources, a lot of finance and stuff. So, but when you say you want to build on your knowledge, maybe you want to learn this skill that will help you do better in this role as a manager or as anything, it's more understandable because it's more realistic, and this is something you don't need money to start working on. So you can build on what you've already started. Just tell your story, okay? So please always make sure that your career plan is connected to the degree you're studying, because you can't be studying master's in agricultural management and then your career plan is to go and work in a hospital. No, your career plan should, you know, be connected to the degree you're studying. Always make sure that the person who has read from your first AC down to this point should understand what you're saying and should believe that this person knows what they're writing about, and this person has been consistently talking about this, so they're actually really passionate about this. So it's not just about telling someone, I'm passionate about teaching, I'm passionate about research, I'm passionate about, you know, healthcare, and there's no evidence, you're just saying it. Anybody can say that. But in my AC, I mentioned that I'll be working on, I will expand my initiative. So I have this like educational initiative that I run, so I mentioned that I'll be expanding on it when I come back, which is an immediate thing as well. Also, I don't need capital to start that. It's just something I can just jump right into by the time I'm done with my degree. One thing I would advise is, whenever you're mentioning your career plan, please also include how that plan is going to benefit the beneficiaries. So mention how it's going to benefit people. So like, for instance, you say once you come back, you're going to, you know, you have a research you are doing, you just needed some skills to be able to complete that research. You can say that once you've published this research, you're going to present it at a conference coming up, and you're going to suggest that these policies or these outcomes are implemented in so area. Or you can say you're going to hold an outreach which is going to benefit so people. So whatever plan you have for your career, please make sure you talk about the results and how it's going to benefit anybody that is going to benefit from it. In general, I would suggest, I think this is about 200, I'm not sure, I think like 200 words. So two plans are okay. You can just mention two and elaborate on them. So don't say, I'm going to start my NGO, I'm going to do outreach, I'm going to open a skill acquisition center, I am going to do, like, you just keep mentioning and you don't explain. Two or three plans are okay, and then make sure you talk about how they are going to benefit the beneficiaries. So so two or three are okay. It's better you just write them and explain very well than just packing, you know, career plans and you don't explain, nobody understands, you're just listing things that are not even feasible. That reminds me, also please write things that are feasible. Don't just write anything that comes to your head. Ask yourself, can you achieve this with minimal capital? Can you achieve this within 5 years? That 5 years is very important. Always keep that in mind. Before you say you want to open a hospital, it might take more than 5 years, but not even have the resources to do that, unless maybe your government is willing to give you some loans or something. So yeah, keep that in mind as well. For the long-term goal, I like to look at it as a continuation of the 5-year career goal. Like, so don't make it so different from your 5 years career goals. So you're not saying you want to create awareness programs in your 5-year career goals, and in your 10 years you're saying something abstract that is not even related to like your work. Yeah, it's true that even some things you say in your short-term goals, you might not be able to like achieve all of them within that 5 years time period. So you can also say you'll be continuing this from here. You understand, some things you would like to start in your short term, they will extend into the long term goals. There's nothing wrong with that. But don't, because it's long term, you're not saying you want to build the biggest research center. It is possible, okay? It is possible, but say something that is more, you know, you don't have to do really, really big things. You can do little things in a big way and it will fill a gap in society. So don't, when they say long-term goal, don't think of like, you know, big things that are like people will see and be like, whoa, like even if you try to sell that dream to somebody, they might be like, no, we don't think we can support this dream because it's too big. It's looking like something a lot of people should has to come together to like support. Make sure that whatever long-term career plans you have, it is related to the SDGs you've chosen. We talked about SDGs in the first part of this video. So while you're writing your development impact essays, I said you should select at least two SDGs. So your career plans, always make sure that they are in line with the SDGs. They are impacting society somehow, and they're in line with the SDGs that you've selected. So I'm going to read how I started my own essay for the long-term career plan. In my quest to become a renowned researcher and global health management specialist, I will continue to carry out cutting-edge research work and constantly push out publication, thus advancing in my career. Then I said, by 2024, 2 years after obtaining my master's degree, I would enroll for a PhD. So this is actually a long-term goal. So a PhD is going to, like I said, a PhD might take me, like before I enroll for that PhD and finish it, you're looking at maybe 6 years from now, because I might want to like take a break before I start my PhD. So that is also what you should look out for. If you love to do a PhD, tell them, let your PhD be also related to what you're working on now. You can tell them what you want to specialize in or where you want to focus on in your PhD. If you don't want to do a PhD, you can tell them other plans that you have as well. Also, another tip I can give you is that if you talked about networking in your objectives during the award, you can maybe talk about like a career plan that would still take you back to networking. Let's say the people you would meet here, you hope to maybe network with them and collaborate to do something maybe in your home country or in their home country somehow. You know, you could talk about collaboration if it's something you're interested in networking. That always sounds well and goes well with long-term plans. Yeah, I also I'm also passionate about education, and I want to encourage, you know, young girls to take on science, you know, to go into STEM and explore scientific innovations and around the world. So that is also part of my long-term goals. So whatever you want to do in the long term, please do not be afraid to state them out. Like I said, in the short term, make sure you outline how these goals are going to benefit your home country or the beneficiaries. Don't just say, I want to do this, full stop. No. Don't list like 100 things. It can be one plan or two plans or at most three plans, so you can have space, because the word count is limited, so you can have space to like explain and tell us how it is going, how you're going to achieve this. So my suggestion would be, state out what that plan is. State, for instance, you want to work in one of the biggest, or you want to work in a major car company in your country. This is your plan. Like I said, use the SMART, always use the SMART method. Like SMART, S means specific, M means measurable, A means achievable, R means relevant, and T means time bound. So be specific. I would love to work in a major car company or in a major software company in my country. M, measurable, how can you measure it? Okay, of course that might not be really applicable in this case, but say you want to start an NGO. So specific, you want to start this NGO. Measurable, if by this period you're able to like gather people or accomplish this and this in so place or community, you would know that you've achieved your goal. And A is attainable. What steps are you going to take to do this? How are you going to attain it? One is that your degree is going to help you. Two, are you going to call for volunteers? Are you going to apply for funding from your government? What steps are you going to take? Then R means relevant. Is it relevant to your future career? So let's say you're studying global health or something, or public health. Starting this NGO is going to help you advance in your career or your goals to make an impact in the global health sector or public health sector of your home country. Then time bound. How many years? Always state out if it's 5 years from now, 6 years from now, 2 quarters from now. you know, the next quarter, always be specific with your timing. So I also mentioned in mind that I will collaborate with international agencies to sensitize rural communities about endemic diseases and appeal for implementation of policies that ensure accessibility of health interventions by those rural communities. So I've been talking about policy implementation. So see how everything is making sense. Whatever it is you want to achieve in your award, make sure it is reflected in every aspect of your essay. So finally, for the voluntary and leadership experience, you know your experience best, but something I will say is, I know you might have volunteered in church, in school, in so many places. Please, even if you want to write other ones, first outline the ones that are closely related to your career, the course you're going to study. If you're into public health, if you're into engineering, if you volunteered in a car dealing company or in a workshop, please mention that first, then others can come. And I would also advise, please, two leadership or three leadership experiences are okay, because you have to tell the story. So I would suggest you use the STAR approach. If you watch the video of the Zoom meeting, someone mentioned, one of our speakers mentioned the STAR approach. So you explain the situation when you volunteered or when you led, what happened, what was the situation. For instance, you noticed that students were failing, or that there was no student body in your department, or there was nobody to stand in for the students in so problem that was happening in your department. And then you talk about T there is the task you did. What did you do? Okay, let's say you called a number of students together, or you met some lecturers or group, or you formed a little organization and, you know, called for volunteers so that you go meet a lecturer to talk about the problem that is bothering the student. And then the A there means action. What action did you take? You went to the lecturer's office, you talked about the issue, you suggested this, and you decided to put this into practice or to implement some kind of policy. And then the R there stands for result. What was the result? What happened? You can say that in the coming semester, the complaints reduced, students were no longer facing this challenge, that. So use that to explain a leadership experience you've had. It doesn't have to be too big. You know, some people say, some people think it's unless you become an SOG president or you've led in one big company. It doesn't have to be big. It could be something as small as, you know, standing up for your classmates, even though you were not a course rep, or standing up for someone else, or taking the lead when there was nobody to carry out a project or an objective. Nobody was there, or the person that was there that was supposed to do it didn't show up, and then you took the initiative. So use this STAR approach to explain one or two incidents where you've had like a voluntary or leadership experience, and then connect it to, there's something I did, I connected it to the ones I hope to do in future. You can just mention briefly, you'd want to continue volunteering or leading in this capacity, as this your previous experiences have helped you or have paved the way for future experiences.